And you got to have enough spiritual sense to believe God for the impossible. You got in the storm. I'm almost finished. But the Bible says he began to get up and rebuke the winds in the sea. And there was a great calm. Now you got to understand something. When he rebuked the wind, he wasn't talking to his father, because they don't rebuke one another. So let me know that the devil got some power to get into the wind. The devil got some power to get into the sea. The devil got power to get into your finances. The devil got power to raise hell on your job. But what I love about God, he didn't give him all the power. He gave all power to his son. He rebuked the wind. He was talking to the devil and said, leave that wind alone. Leave the sea alone. I can hear God talking to the devil saying, leave my daughter alone. Leave my son alone. Enough. Are you picking with my child? I had enough. Are you picking with their finances? I had enough. Are you messing with their children? Leave them alone. Look at your neighbor and say, honey, I'm coming out of this storm. But the man marveled. Let me read that again. But the man marveled. Saying, what man of man is this? See, many times we don't really know who we're serving until we get into a storm that seems impossible. That's an opportunity for God to prove that he's God. The disciples said, I know they said, I've seen him heal the sick. I've seen him raise the dead. But I never experienced this before. I never seen him speak to the wind. I never seen him speak to the sea. What manner of man is this? But what they didn't realize, I can tell you what type of man he was. He was the King of Kings. He was the lily of the valley. He was the rose of Sharon. He was the bright morning star. They didn't realize the awesome supernatural power that God has. And the devil don't want you to realize the supernatural power that God has. Last verse. But the man Mark said, what man? A man is this, that even the winds and the sea obey him.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Even the winds and the sea obey him.
Only God.
I don't care how mean that judge is. When God says set him free, the judge got to obey him. I'm talking to somebody right now. Yeah. You may be waiting on something special.
Yeah.
And the Lord said, I don't know how I'm going to do this for you. And God speak to the judge how the judge got to obey you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You're not in the storm
by yourself.
By yourself.
Thank you, God.
You're not in the storm by yourself. Joe might have walked off, but you're still not in the storm by yourself. Joe might not be bringing a check home, but you're still not in the storm. In the house or driving in the car by yourself, but you're still not in the storm.
Yes,
yourself. And I know the enemy going to fight some of y'all tomorrow tonight, but you got to tell yourself, I'm still not in the storm.
Oh, yeah.
Hey! Amen.
Amen.
Step to your feet quickly. Glory to God. You that been going through a storm. Everybody's not in the same storm. Some just came out. Some just went in. Some is still there. Some getting ready to enter into another. But you're not in the storm by yourself. The enemy wants us to think that we're by ourselves. But I'm here to tell you, you're not in.
Thank you, Lord.
The storm.
Yes, sir.
By yourself. Where was Jesus when they was in the storm? The Bible said he was asleep. Resting. Because he knew he had it all in control. What do I do when I'm in a storm, Pastor? Just sleep and just rest. You can't do nothing about the bill anyhow. Worry about it, ain't gonna do nothing but create another bill. Just rest. Just rest. I had to learn years ago not to worry about nothing. Even when the pressure's on. Don't let the devil see you sweat. Because while we're worried about it, God has already worked the problem out. But we too busy worrying, we can't see him working out. But you are not in the storm by yourself. If you're in a storm right now, glory to God. Don't be ashamed to make your way to the altar. I want to pray for you. Don't be ashamed to make your way to the altar. Glory to God. I'm speaking to someone even right now that's watching us on YouTube. You may be in your home or on your job and going through a storm and don't know how you're going to make it. I want you to know you're not in a storm by yourself. The same God that got up and rebuked the wind and rebuked the storms, he's going to rebuke some things in your life that tried to steal your joy and your peace. If you're going through a storm right now, don't be ashamed. Make your way to the altar. I want to pray for you right now. Because some storms are not bad. Some storms, brother, build you up. Prepare you for something you're not quite ready for. Right now. Many storms come because God is trying to prepare us for ministry that we're not ready for right now. We got too many people preaching, but ain't been through nothing. That's why the anointing of God is not there. But God is saying right now, don't be ashamed. Glory to God. Don't be ashamed. It's a joy. We ask that you send peace. We ask that you send strength. In the midst of their storm. And Father God,
right now,
let them know that all storm is not bad. Some storms come to build them up. Some storms come to give them strength. God, I thank you right now. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Listen, we're getting ready to take our office ministry.
God bless you. God bless you. This vision. This vision. Amen.
Stand to your feet.
Hold somebody's hand if you will. Working on a number of stuff out here. Pastor Harmon, it's a blessing to me.
Yeah.
It's a blessing to me. I see. He's a blessing to me. A lot of times people don't understand that Jesus needed encouragement.
Yeah.
He's been encouraging to me.
Yeah.
More like a song.
Yeah.
I thank God for him, this magnificent wife.
Yeah.
Such an anointing on her life, isn't it?
Yeah.
They're just going to do what the Lord asked me to do. He believed God. So this ministry, something. Go ahead and get it, brother Patrick. Believe that God showed this marriage what, some 13 years ago?
Uh-huh.
Amen. It didn't look like this, but you know. God is able to do anything but fail. Amen. The Lord did a lot of things like that. He's in charge of this part of this segment. I'm just visiting. Don't think about me, I love church.
Amen.
And my wife gets upset sometimes that I used to leave church and go fellowship with everybody else before I got home. I used to be 9, 10 o'clock getting home, but I'd be in church.
Amen.
God is good all the time.
Yes,
He's going to tell you in the near future what He's going to do with us. This is kind of what I've been looking for in a way. We used to have evangelism service on Friday night. We were working on that.
Amen.
He's going to let you know when His first Friday night service is going to be. Could be this week, could be next week. He's going to let you know. So we got running by the preacher. Pastor, is it okay? Amen. Let's go have a magnificent time where we're praising and magnifying God. Is that all right?
Yeah.
We're not dying, we're going to come alive.
Yeah.
We're going to come alive. God is not through yet, is He?
No, He's not.
He may be in the ship.
Yeah.
Either way.
Oh, yeah.
And He has everything.
Yeah.
In control. In the name of Jesus Christ,
yes.
Son of the living God, bless thee, your so great a people in this place. Thank you for sending anointed people, people that are not sure on themselves, are puffed up, and willing to see people healed and delivered and set free. God, we thank you for them.
Thank you, God.
Bless them now, God.
Bless
my mate, God, and see.
Yes.
Aid and assist them in whatever they want to do over here.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Yes, ma'am.
And let these people realize they've been under the anointing today.
Yes, Lord.
The influence of the Holy Ghost was here.
Yes.
Take them from this place, God, but never from your prison.
Yes.
Bring them back here at the appointed time, God. We give you all the praise and all the glory. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm Pastor Larry Hunter, standing here with Bishop Carroll from Memphis, Tennessee. We're excited to let you know that we're going to be having service here. There's a service going to be here at 10:15. Then there's another one at 12:15. And we're just looking for God to do something great and awesome. Bishop, what would you say to somebody right now that's watching us on YouTube and maybe going through a little storm and don't know which way to turn? What would you say to them?
I would say that God is able to deliver them out of any storm that they find themselves in. We here at Pomerland Ministry Church, we believe in love, showing love. God said He first gave us love, and we believe in showing it back to the people. If you don't have a church home, or if you're in a church, you're not happy or satisfied there, you're not growing. We promise you 100%, if you come here and listen to the Word of God, you'll grow. And that's our promise to you. God bless you. May heaven smile on you. That's our prayer.
God bless you. And if you need anything, amen, if you need prayer, you can reach me at airport 901-581-2860. And Bishop, would you like to give your number out if they'd
We're here at Pomerland Ministry at 1994 Southern. My phone number is airport 901-299-8562. That's airport 901-299-8562. God bless you now.
God bless you.